We would continue the discussion that we started in last class. We started with this generalized Rodrigues formula and made an assumption that the function Sx is of a zeroth degree polynomial or a constant and got the Hermite polynomial. In this sub lecture, I will just assume that it is linear and let's see what do we get. It will turn out we will get a so called Laguerre polynomial. Okay. So, this I will call as choice 2, okay. And what is the main choice we are making? S of this is a linear function. So, I am just using x prime instead of x for the initial part of the calculation. You will see the reason, because at the end of getting the polynomial, I would shift the origin a bit and go to the usual x coordinate. That is because the polynomial that is usually referred to as Laguerre polynomial conventionally has a certain domain of applicability, and to match that the coordinate frame is shifted a little bit. So, convenient for me to just use x prime instead of x from the beginning and then change over to x. It does not matter at this moment, it for you it does not matter, because whether it is x or x prime it is the same. So, just think that this is the continuous variable that we have, and this is main point is that it is linear, and of course, we have c1 x prime is equal to as yesterday this. Then we go to, and this is first degree polynomial. So, we go to the generalized Rodrigues formula and we use with n is equal to 1 and just substitute these. So, that is c1 x prime would be minus 1 by k1 x prime, but that according to the general formula will be k1 1 divided by w d x prime of w into s. S is this, okay, and then we just proceed. As you can see, this would become minus w x prime. We may, or let us not first write w multiplying, I will just write this minus x prime is equal to 1 by w. Let us see from here, if I take w out and take differentiation of x prime plus 1, that will give me 1. So, I will get one term which is this, and plus 1 by w, then x prime plus 1 and dw dx, okay. So, this is giving me 1, which I can take to this side and make it minus 1, and so it will be x prime plus 1, and this is x prime plus 1 dw dx, okay, dx prime, sorry. So, and now in general we are talking of any general variable, so there is no necessity for x prime to take a specific value. X prime we can ignore the fact that x prime is equal to minus 1 is going to lead to an equality, but just cancel this off, and if you do that, in that case you are going to get, so there is a w here, you are going to get minus x prime is equal to log of w, or in other words w is equal to e to the power of x prime. This is again we are ignoring any prefactor that is there, okay. Now with this w we can put the boundary conditions. And what are those? That is w a prime s a prime is equal to w b prime s b prime is equal to 0 W is of this form, so e to the power of minus a prime. What is s? S is a prime plus 1, that is equal to W b prime, W b prime again e to the power of minus b prime, and what is s? 1 plus b prime. All these we set to 0. And what are then the possibilities? Well, the lower value we can take to be a prime equal to minus 1, which will satisfy this. So a prime is equal to minus 1 will satisfy this, while and b prime is equal to infinity will satisfy this. Okay, so these are two possibilities. But then we say that the polynomial, what finally we are getting, this would imply that from Rodrigue's formula for general n, so this we did for n is equal to 1, now for general n, this x prime is 1 by kn 1 by w dn dx to the x prime to the power n ws to the power n, which can be written explicitly as 1 divided by kn e to the power of x prime 1 by w, mind you. So this will become e to the power of x prime and d d dn dx prime n e to the power of minus x prime, which is w, into s to the power n. S is x prime plus 1 to the power n. This is the formula then of the polynomial that we have got. Now conventionally what is done, the origin is shifted, origin of the coordinate axis is shifted such that we get and let us call that new variable as x, such that we write x is equal to x prime plus 1. Okay, if we do that, or x prime is equal to x minus 1, whatever. So then you go and substitute it here. Of course, a polynomial which is of nth degree, under substitution x prime is equal to x minus 1 will still remain polynomial of nth degree. Only it will look, its constants will look different, and that is what is conventionally called as the Laguerre polynomial. So Cn x prime under the substitution, the shifting of the origin, would go to ln x. This is the new polynomial that we have, and let us just in this formula substitute this. X prime is equal to x minus 1 e to the power of x minus 1. Bottom we have kn. And there would be some normalization that has to be slipped in. Ddx prime will become ddx, that you can see for sure. So we don't have to worry about that. E to the power of minus x prime is going to become x plus 1, and x prime plus 1 is going to become x to the n. So this is going to cancel like that. Okay, and then there is some convention, this is kn is taken to be n factorial and hn is taken to be 1. Okay, so finally this is how the normalized Laguerre polynomial looks: e to the power of x divided by n factorial, square root of hn, but in this case hn is just simply 1, so we need not have written this also. But I am just writing to remind you that usually there is a normalization, dn dx to the power of n e to the power of minus x x to the power of n. This formula that you have got is now for this famous polynomial called the Laguerre polynomial. Okay. So this is the Laguerre polynomial, and of course you can wonder what happens to the weight function. weight function x prime will be replaced by x minus 1, so that will just become x minus e to the power of minus x and a constant, but we have been ignoring constants anyway, the constant prefactor in all of these. So w x will continue to be e to the power of minus x, the constant prefactor can always be ignored, that is what we have said. And now look at the domain of applicability of this. X prime is equal to minus 1 implies, x prime is equal to minus 1 implies x is equal to 0. This we will call as our A, the value A of the domain, while x prime equal to infinity implies x is equal to infinity, which we will continue to call as B. So finally we get A is equal to 0, B is equal to infinity. These are the three defining sort of, this is the defining formula for the Laguerre polynomial, this is the weight function, and this is the domain of applicability. Okay. Now, of course, in this discussion like yesterday, we started with Sx is equal to half. Now somebody may say, why half? We can call it some alpha. Likewise, you can say, we can have some constant into x prime and some constant here. That will be the most general thing to do. And in fact, that general thing can be done. Only the steps are little more, the algebra you have to little more carefully do. But putting the more general linear form S is equal to beta x minus alpha, it may be shown that you get the so-called associated Laguerre polynomial. Denoted by the symbol L nu nx with the W function being x to the power nu e to the power of minus x, where nu has to be, the math leads to this, and the domain of applicability is x is equal to 0 to infinity. Okay. So very similar domain, this is replaced by x to the power nu, and the polynomial itself has another index nu. So we note that whatever we were calling as the Laguerre polynomial is just, so ordinary Laguerre polynomial ln x is nothing but L nu equal to 0 n x. Okay, so that is something you can note, that whatever we were calling as this Laguerre polynomial is also related to the more general Laguerre polynomial, which is with its nu index being 0. Thank you.